गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ड्यूरिंग दिस रिवीजन सेशन टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 2B. वी विल डू द रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर 2B, टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस. बिफोर वी प्रोसीड दिस टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन, वी विल सी रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज. दिस रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड मेटल एक्टिविटी सीरीज और मेटल रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज और सिंपली रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज. सी, ऑल मेटल्स आर रिएक्टिव. दे ऑल रिएक्ट, ऑल मेटल्स रिएक्ट विथ डाइल्यूट एसिड्स. दिस डाइल्यूट एसिड मे बी सल्फ्यूरिक, डाइल्यूट सल्फ्यूरिक, मे बी डाइल्यूट हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड. All metals react with moisture. Moisture means water. All metals react with air. Air means oxygen. So on the basis of, but different metals react with these things at different rates. So according to the rate of reaction of metals with dilute acids, moisture and air, the metals are arranged in a decreasing order of their reactivity. The metal which is most reactive, they are kept on top, and which are least reactive, they are kept at the bottom. Here I have written like this. Gold and platinum, both, they do not react with dilute acids, water and air. If you see some of the books, after copper, mercury, silver, it is written gold and platinum. In some of the books, copper, mercury, silver, platinum and gold. So that's why I have given here a slash. Whatsoever you want to write will be okay. So this is most reactive, this is less reactive, this is much less, less, less and less. It is arranged in descending order of their reactivity. Now we will come to the types of chemical reactions. There are mainly 4 types of chemical reactions. Since we have already studied these things, so I am giving you the summary only. During this revision, we will not discuss about all the points. Which are the main points, we will discuss with them. You can go through the books yourself. Here, there are 4 types of chemical reaction. One is direct combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, and double decomposition reactions. This direct combination reactions, this direct combination, in fact it is direct combination reaction. It is also called as synthesis reaction. In this reactions, 2 substances combine, means 2 reactants react and form a single product. Two reactants reacts form a single product. The 2 reactants may be element, may be compound, may be both. If you see here in all these 3, there are 2 reactants and only products. So what I had said, the reactants may be element. Here, both are elements, form a single product. Here is one element and one compound, form a single product. H2O2, it is called hydrogen peroxide. Here, both the reactants are compounds. Both the reactants are compounds and form a single product, magnesium hydroxide. So during our indirect combination reactions, 2 reactants will be there, both the reactants may be element, both the reactants may be compound or one may be element, another one may be compound, but the product will always will be a single product. Then decomposition reactions. In these reactions, when a single compound is heated, so single compound on heating, it decomposes, it dissociates, it breaks up into two or more substances. Single reactant on heating breaks up. The products may be elements, may be compounds, or may be both. See here. When, as in our book, what is this? When water is strongly heated, it forms hydrogen and oxygen. When it is strongly heated at a temperature of about 2500 to 3000, water dissociates, it decomposes to form hydrogen and oxygen. When sodium chloride salt is electrolyzed, it forms sodium and chlorine. So one compound is decomposed, is broken down in two elements. Here potassium nitrate, when heated, it formed KNO2. This was KNO3. Nitrate, it was ATE, nitrate. It is KNO2, ITE, nitrite. One compound plus one element is formed. Likewise, when zinc carbonate is heated, it forms zinc oxide and carbon dioxide. Sometimes it may be also possible like this, lead nitrate, when heated, it will form lead oxide. This is your NO2, nitrogen dioxide plus this. Two compounds may be formed and one element is formed. So, since this reaction takes place only on heating, therefore this decomposition reaction is also called as thermal decomposition reactions, because this, then what is thermal decomposition reaction or decomposition reactions? The reaction in which a compound on heating breaks up into two or more substances are called decomposition reaction or thermal decomposition reactions. Now, third type of reaction is displacement reaction. Just right now, we had seen in reactivity series, the metal which is highly reactive, they are placed on the top. That means this is most reactive, this is least, and least, and less, not least, but less, and less. So, in the chemical reaction, in which the highly reactive, more reactive metals displaces or replaces the less reactive, such reactions are called displacement reactions. So in displacement reaction, more reactive metals replaces or displaces the less reactive metals. Here when zinc reacts with sulfuric acid, it forms zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gas is evolved. This arrow means it goes up. My dear students, we know all the gases goes up. So this symbol can be given to indicate that gas is formed. So see, what was our reactivity series? potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, then zinc. After zinc, it was iron, tin, lead, then it was hydrogen. So, zinc is more reactive than hydrogen. So, zinc here replaces hydrogen. This H2SO4, this was H2SO4. So, this H2SO4, this H2 means hydrogen was replaced by more reactive metal zinc. Right? Then, fourth type of reaction is double decomposition reactions. Double decomposition reaction, it is also known as double displacement reactions. How this reactions takes place? This is the definition. I have written the definition of double decomposition reaction, but you can understand and write the definition. A reaction in which, in this reaction, reactants will be two compounds, not elements, only two compounds, only the compounds, two compounds will react. After reaction, only two products will be formed and both will be compounds. So, two reactants react and two products are formed. Two compound products are formed. The reaction will take place only in aqueous or solution state. This was the third condition. Now, what is the fourth condition? One precipitate, in short we write PPT, one precipitate may be formed or may not be formed. Now, if we combine all these four points, we will get the definition of double decomposition reaction. So, a chemical reaction in which two compounds react to form two products, and the reactions takes place in aqueous or solution state, in which one precipitate may or may not be formed. See here, copper sulfate, it is a compound. Sodium hydroxide is a compound. After reaction, they form white precipitate of calcium hydroxide. We give this symbol. This means it goes down, means precipitate plus sodium sulfate, another compound is formed. Likewise, when this is ferrous chloride, my dear students, if we write this FeCl3, it will be ferric chloride. This is your ferrous chloride. When ferrous chloride reacts with sodium hydroxide, it forms ferrous hydroxide as precipitate, green precipitate, and sodium chloride. So, see, in both the reactions, two compounds react, two products are formed. Here, one precipitate is formed. Now, this double decomposition reaction is of two types. First one is your neutralization reaction. Here, I have written Za. Even we can write SA, both are correct, no one is wrong. So, neutralization reaction. What is neutralization reaction? A reaction between acid and base is called neutralization reaction. Here is your acid, here is your base. When sulfuric acid reacts with ammonium hydroxide, ammonium sulfate plus water is formed. This is the general trend, this is the general concept, that acid reacts with base, it forms salt and water. So here acid and base reacts, form salt and water, no precipitates are formed. So the double decomposition reaction in which no precipitates are formed, they are neutralization reaction. And what is neutralization reaction? A reaction between acid and base is called neutralization reaction. Another one is your precipitation reaction, a chemical reaction in which one precipitate is formed. If you see, in both the cases you see, here two compounds are reacting, two products are formed, but no precipitate is formed. Here also zinc sulfate one compound, sodium hydroxide another compound, product is zinc hydroxide and sodium sulfate. Two compounds are formed, they are taking place in aqueous solution and one precipitate is formed. Here no precipitate, here precipitate will be formed. So double decomposition reaction, a chemical reaction in which two reactants react and two products are formed. The reactions takes place in aqueous or solution state and one precipitate may be formed or may not be formed are called double decomposition reaction, or it is also known as your double displacement reactions. We should know this reactivity series. So my dear students, we will meet on the next class. Wish you all the best. Wish you a happy Janmashtami. See you. Bye bye.